Hey, what's up? Mike Z back again, and we are here with
Mr. Michael Barton,
a member of the Trek family.
Indeed.
And Mr. Michael Barton, tell us what you think about Trek drums.
Well, what can I say about a drum company that I've been with for over 20 years? Well, the first thing I'll tell you is I don't play anything else. I have a recording studio, and the microphone tells all. Now, let's just say this. I do have some wood drums because I also teach. But they don't go under the microphone. The only thing that goes under the microphone and gets printed out for the world to hear is Trek drums. And there's a reason for that. These drums are consistently made from shelf to shelf to shelf. I can't have it any other way, especially when somebody's coming to my studio and they're paying for a lot of time to be recorded, and I pretty much insist that they use the drums that I have in the studio, and I guarantee you, 10 out of 10 times, the drummers walk away going, I want those. What you want for them? Talk to my buddy Mike and Mike Z, and he just might get a going on with the drums. But honestly, in all seriousness, there isn't any other thing that I'd play. I'm not going to play anything else for the rest of my life. I've been with these guys forever, and I plan to stay here forever.
Very good. Very good. And, well, here forever meaning Trek drums, not this really, really, really noisy vintage show.
No. Hold on. Let me show you some of the most important tools that I have at the show here. It's more important than drumsticks. Earplugs.
Earplugs.
Let me give you a little idea.
I had Captain to put creatures into my ears.
No. What? Yeah. Yeah.
Well, this is Michael Barton, very important member of the Trek family, and we are happy to have him here. And we'll be right back with you.
Yeah.